He who even accepted to suffer for us. Let your mercies, O Lord, come quickly to your aid, to our aid, for we are utterly poor. Help us, O God, our Saviour, for the glory of your name. O Lord, deliver us and have mercy on our sins for your name's sake. Holy God, holy strong, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy strong, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy strong, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the age of ages. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our iniquities. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father in heaven, may your name be sanctified. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
The reign of the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the age of the ages. Amen.
Amen. The thief's repentance plundered paradise, but the myrrh-bearer's lament disclosed the joy that you had risen Christ God, granting the world great mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
O heavenly King, Comforter, Spirit of Truth, everywhere present, filling all things, treasury of blessings, giver of life, come and abide in us, cleanse us from all impurity, and of thy goodness save our souls. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth thy praise.
For the Lord will have holy mercy.
Blessed is our God, always now and ever, and in the ages of ages.
Amen. Pray for me, Holy Master.
The Lord direct thy steps into every good work.
Remember me, Holy Master.
Lord, remember thy diaconate in his kingdom, always now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. The Lord remember your priesthood in his kingdom. All the time we have earned to the ages you are. Blessed is the King. Not yet, no. Yes.
Master, give a blessing.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from on high, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who enter in with faith, reverence and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Archbishop Gregorius, Metropolitan Kallistos, Metropolitan Nicolaus, for the honored order of the presbyters and the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and for all the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Our Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth, the Royal Family, the Government and all in civil authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city, town and village, and for the faithful who dwell in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O faithful, the earth and temperate seasons, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by land, air, or water, for the sick, the suffering, for those in captivity, and for their safety and salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and constraint, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our all holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Mother of God, the Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us entrust ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our Lord.
To you, O Lord.
For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within. Bless his holy name.
At the prayers of the Mother of God, O Saviour, save us.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget none of his rewards.
As the fiat misericordiae, sotte sos omnimas.
Κύριος εν το ουρανό, ετοίμασε τον θρόνο αυτού, και η βασιλεία αυτού πάντων δεσπόζει.
Τες πρεσβείες της Θεοτόκου, σώτε σώσον ημάς.
Ευλογείτε τον Κύριον πάντα τα έργα αυτού, εν παντή τόπο της δεσποτείας αυτού, ευλόγη η ψυχή μου τον Κύριον.
Τες πρεσβείες της Θεοτόκου, σώτε σώσον ημάς.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen.
At the prayers of the Mother of God, O Saviour, save us.
Again and again in peace, let us pray unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Serve us, save, comfort, and preserve us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Mindful of our most holy and undefiled, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Mother of God and ever Virgin Mary, and of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For yours is the light, and yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, O my soul. While I live, I will praise the Lord. While I exist, I will praise my God.
Son of God, risen from the dead, save us who sing to you, alleluia.
Blessed are those whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord their God.
Son of God, risen from the dead, save us who sing to you, alleluia.
Who made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is within them.
Son of God, risen from the dead, save us who sing to you, alleluia.
Βασιλεύσει Κύριος εις τον αιώνα, ο Θεός ουσιών, εις γενεάν και γενεάν. Σώσον ημάς, Υιέ Θεού, ο Αναστάς εκ νεκρών, ψαλλοντάς η Αλληλούια. Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι.
Και νυν και αεί και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν. Only begotten Son and Word of God, who being immortal,
chained, becoming man. You were crucified, Christ God, by death trampling on death, being one of the Holy Trinity, glorified with the Father and the Holy Spirit. Save us.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Venerating our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Mother of God, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us entrust ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To you,
εις τον αιώνα το έλεος αυτού, του λίθους φραγιστέντος υπό των Ιουδαίων και στρατιώτων φυλασσόντων το άρχαντον σου σώμα, ανέστης πλημερος σωτήρ, high priests and martyrs, let us
cry out with one accord, glory to the one who crowned you, glory to the one who made you holy, glory to the one who revealed you as our champions in dangers.
For thou, O God, art holy, and to thee we give glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Yeah.
Let us attend. Peace be with you all.
And with thy spirit.
Let us attend.
The readings from the first epistle. May your mercy, Lord, be upon us as we have hoped in you.
Let us attend.
Rejoice in the Lord, you just. Praise befits the upright.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the first epistle of Paul to the Corinthians.
Let us attend.
Brethren, everything is lawful for me, but not everything is beneficial. Everything is lawful for me, but I will not be dominated by anything. Food is meant for the stomach, and the stomach for food. And God will do away with both one and the other. The body is meant not for fornication, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. God not only raised the Lord, he will raise us too by his power. Do you not know that the bodies are members of Christ? Shall I therefore take the members of Christ and make them members of a prostitute? Never. For do you not know that whoever is joined to a prostitute becomes one body with her? For it says, the two shall become one flesh. But anyone who is joined to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Flee fornication. Every other sin that a person commits is outside of the body, but the fornicator sins against his own body. For do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God, and that you do not belong to yourself? For you were bought at a price, and therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit. These are of the Lord.
Peace be to you,
and with thy spirit. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom, stand and attend. Let us listen to the Holy Gospel. Peace be with you all.
And with thy spirit.
The reading is from the Gospel according to St. Luke.
Let us attend.
The Lord
glory
spoke
to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
The Lord spoke this parable. There was a man who had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the share of property that falls to me. And he divided the living between them. Not many days later, the younger son gathered all he had and took his journey into a far country. And there he squandered his property in loose living. And when he had spent everything, a great famine arose in that country. And he began to be in want. So he went and joined himself to one of the citizens of that country, who sent him into his fields to feed swine. And he would gladly have fed on the pots that the swine ate, and no one gave him anything. But when he came to himself and said, how many of my father's hired servants have bread enough and to spare, but I perish here with hunger. I will arise and go to my father, and I will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Treat me as one of your hired servants. And he arose and came to his father. But while he was yet at a distance, his father saw him and had compassion, and ran and embraced him and kissed him. And the Son said to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. But the father said to his servants, Bring quickly the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet, and bring the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and make merry, for this son was dead and is alive again, and was lost and is found. And they began to make merry. Now his eldest son was in the field, and as he came and drew near to the house, he heard music and dancing, and he called one of the servants and asked what this meant. And he said to him, Your brother has come, and your father has killed the fatted calf, because he has received him safe and sound. But he was angry and refused to go in. His father came out and entreated him, but he answered his father, Behold, these many years I've served you, and I've never disobeyed your command. Yet you never gave me a kid that I might make merry with my friends. But when this son of yours came, who has devoured your living with harlots, you killed for him the fatted calf. And he said to him, Son, you are always with me, and all that is mine is yours. It was fitting to make merry and be glad, for this your brother was dead and is alive. He was lost and is found.
Peace be to you who have proclaimed the gospel.
Glory.
Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This Sunday, we have listened to the gospel story of the prodigal son. This is the second of the Sundays in preparation for the coming fast of Lent. And in this gospel for the prodigal son, we have set before us an icon of repentance. And let us notice three phrases from the gospel. He came to himself, I will arise and go, and he arose and came. In those three phrases, we see three stages of repentance. The first stage is he came to himself. The beginning of repentance is to realize who we are and where we are. The prodigal son comes to himself, understands that he is in exile, in the exile of sin, and he sees all the bitterness and futility of the life of sin that he has been pursuing. So that is the first stage of repentance, self-knowledge, self-understanding, to see what is our situation. As it says in the Shepherd of Hermas, repentance is a great understanding. And this is exactly the meaning of the Greek word for repentance, metanoia, literally change of mind. To repent is to look at ourselves, at one another, and at God in a new way. It is to reverse the perspective, to stand the pyramid on its head. Repentance is not just a feeling of guilt, not necessarily an emotional crisis, a paroxysm of remorse. Repentance is certainly not self-pity or self-hatred. It is, yes, conversion of one's mind, altering one's way of thinking, recentering oneself. That is the first stage. And we are to ask ourselves, in the coming fast of Lent, shall I come to myself in some new way? But in itself, the feeling of self-understanding is not yet repentance. The prodigal in exile might have concluded, my situation is hopeless, I've wrecked my life, I can't go back again to the Father, I've wasted my inheritance, so there is no future for me. Repentance is not that kind of attitude. Repentance is not despair. We see in the story of the prodigal how, having come to himself, he then forms a further resolution. I will arise, he says, and go. All is not lost. I can return to my Father. Of course, says the prodigal to himself, I cannot expect to be restored to my previous position, but at least perhaps he will find a place for me among his hired servants. So the prodigal's repentance is true repentance, because he sees not just the misery of his present condition, but the possibility of a way out. As St. John Climacus affirms, repentance is the daughter of hope and the denial of despair. We may contrast here the two figures of Judas and Peter. Judas did indeed come to himself after he had betrayed the Savior, but he did not truly repent, because when he came to himself, he was plunged into despair, and he went out and hanged himself, committed suicide. That was not real repentance. But in Peter's case, we see true repentance. He denied Christ three times, and when he realized what he had done, when he came to himself, he wept bitterly. But that was not the end of the story. After the resurrection, when he saw Christ standing on the bank of the lake, he didn't turn away and say, there's no point in my going back to him, he will never accept me. But on the contrary, with hope, he cried out, it is the Lord, and he plunged into the waters and returned to Christ. And Christ restored him, feed my sheep, feed my lambs. So there, in the case of Peter, we see true repentance. When he came to himself, he realized, this is not the end. I can return to the Savior. I can offer him my repentance and ask his forgiveness. So this is the second stage of repentance, to have a feeling of fresh hope, to realize that there is forgiveness and new life. So repentance is not to look backwards but forwards, not to look down but to look up, not to see what we have failed to be, but to see what we can become through Christ's cross and his resurrection. We need to forgive others, yes, but we need also to forgive ourselves. And that is the second stage of repentance, to come to fresh hope, to forgive ourselves. But that is not enough to have a feeling of hope. There must come a third stage, the stage of action. The prodigal son doesn't merely say, well, perhaps I could go back again. But we are told he arose and came. Great understanding, self-knowledge, the first stage. New hope, the second stage. Has to be followed by a third stage, action. Repentance does not just consist in noble feelings. Repentance is not just to entertain grand intentions. Repentance is to do something about this, and to do it now. The present moment, of which we have been speaking more than once in this conference, is an essential element in repentance. As St. Paul says, in the second epistle to the Corinthians, behold, now is the acceptable time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. That is the essence of our great understanding. The devil says to us, yesterday or tomorrow. He wants us to dwell in the past with nostalgia, or to think about the future, but to do nothing about it. But the Holy Spirit says, not yesterday and not tomorrow, the Holy Spirit says to us, today, today. So then, this Lent, shall I come to a greater self-knowledge? Shall I come to new hope? And shall I act upon that new hope, carry it out into practice? Those are the three stages. Let us apply them to ourselves. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us all sing with our whole soul and with all our mind, let us sing.
Lord have mercy.
Lord Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray you hear and have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy, we pray you hear and have mercy.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Metropolitan Nicholas, and for all our brotherhood in Christ.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Also we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon and forgiveness of sins for the servants of God, all devout and Orthodox Christians, those who dwell in your physical city and parish, the wardens and members of this church and their families, and the participants of this conference.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Also we pray for the blessed and ever-remembered founders of this holy church, and for our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest before us, and who lie here asleep in the true faith, and for the Orthodox everywhere.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Also we pray for those who bring offerings
offerings, those who care for the beauty of this holy and venerable house, for those who labor in its service, for those who sing, and for the people here present, who await your great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For thou, O God, art merciful and lovest mankind, and to thee we give glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
That ye do is pray unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us, the faithful, pray for the catechumens, that the Lord may have mercy upon them, that he may instruct them in the word of truth, that he may reveal unto them the gospel of righteousness, that he may unite them to his holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. Save them, have mercy upon them, protect and preserve them, O God, by thy grace. The catechumens bow down your heads unto the Lord.
To you, O Lord.
That with us they also may glorify thine all honorable and majestic name, of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us, the faithful, again and again in peace, pray unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
For to thee belongs all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
From all affliction, wrath, danger, and constraint, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom.
That being always guarded by thy might, we may give glory to thee, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Thank you.
May the Lord God remember in his kingdom
His All Holiness, the Ecumenical Patriarch Bartholomew, our Archbishop Gregorios, our Metropolitan Nicholas, and all our brotherhood in Christ. May he remember in his kingdom our Sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth and all the royal family, Parliament and all in seats of authority, and all the people, always, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom my brothers and fellow celebrants, the priest Andrew, the deacons Michael, Eleftherios, and Richard. May he remember in his kingdom all the members of the Friends of Mount Athos and all the monks of the Holy Mountain. May he remember in his kingdom all who are ill, all who mourn, all who are in anxiety and distress of mind, all who are persecuted and imprisoned for their faith, all who have asked for our intercessions, always, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Pantonimon ke pantonton epsebon ke orthodoxon Christianon mnisti Kyrios o Theos en ti vasilia aftu pantos en in ke ai ke Iscus eonas ton eono.
Oras utile.
Nomen Deus
Thou it was who didst bring us from nothing into being,
and when we had fallen away, didst raise us up again, and didst not cease to do all things until thou hadst brought us up to heaven and granted us thy kingdom, which is to come. For all these things we give thanks to thee and to thine only begotten Son and to thy Holy Spirit, for all the blessings that we have received, whether known or unknown, whether manifest or hidden. We thank thee also for this liturgy which thou hast been pleased to accept from our hands, though there stand about thee thousands of archangels and tens of thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring aloft upon their wings, singing, crying, shouting the triumphal hymn, and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord of Sabaoth, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Send down thy Holy Spirit upon us, and upon these gifts he hath set forth. And make this bread the precious body of thy Christ. Amen. And that which is in this cup, the precious blood of thy Christ. Amen. Changing them by thy Holy Spirit. Amen. 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 So that those who partake may receive vigilance of soul, remission of sins, communion in thy Holy Spirit, fulfillment in the kingdom of heaven, freedom to speak in thy presence and not judgment or condemnation. Also we offer thee this spiritual worship for those who have gone to their rest in faith, forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and every righteous spirit made perfect in faith. Above all, for our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, Mother of God, and ever Virgin Mary.
Holy, heavenly, and ideal altar as a sweet spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Deliverance from all affliction, all danger and constraint. Let us pray to the Lord.
Domine miluiește.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Domine miluiește.
That the whole day being perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
An angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
All things that are good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
A Christian ending to our life, painless, peaceful and unashamed, and good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Having asked for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us entrust ourselves and one another and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
Account us worthy, Master, with boldness without condemnation, dared to call upon you, the God of heaven, as Father, and to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And to your spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord.
To you, Lord.
Through grace and compassion of God towards mankind, for our only begotten sons and our blessed, together with you all, the good and life-giving spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us return.
The holy gift for those who are holy.
Fled Adam out of paradise.
but through the cross, Christ led back in the thief as he cried, "Remember me when you come in your kingdom." The death of sin ever holds me fast, and the tempest of transgressions overwhelms me. Pilate me, O Christ, my God, to the haven of life, and save me, O King of glory. I have wasted in evil, living the riches which the Father gave me, and now I am brought to poverty. I am filled with shame, enslaved to fruitless thoughts. Therefore I cry unto you, who loves mankind, take pity on me and save me. Ευλογημένοι αυτών εν της υψίστης. Αλληλούια.
Christ, the Son of the living God, who camest into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. Again, I believe that this is indeed thine own pure body, and that this is indeed thine own precious blood. Therefore, I pray to thee, have mercy upon me, forgive me my sins, both voluntary and involuntary, in word and in deed, in knowledge and in ignorance, and count me worthy, uncondemned, to receive thy most pure mysteries, for remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. At thy mystical supper, Son of God, today receive me as a communicant, for I will not speak of the mystery to thine enemies. I will not give thee a kiss like Judas, but as the thief I confess thee, remember me, Lord, when thou comest in thy kingdom. Not unto judgment nor unto condemnation be the partaking of thy most pure body and blood unto me, but for healing of soul and body. Pure and holy, body and blood of Christ, the servant of God, Marina, receives the most precious, pure and holy, body and blood of Christ, the servant of God, Marina, receives the most precious, pure and holy, body and blood of Christ, unto remission of sins, and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, John, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ unto remission of sins and life everlasting. The servant of God, Gregory, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ unto remission of sins and life everlasting. The servant of God, Margaret, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ. The servant of God, Rayo, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ. The servant of God, Vasiliki, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ unto remission of sins. The servant of God, Marie Christiane, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ unto remission of sins and life everlasting. The servant of God, Christine, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Cosmas, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Susan, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, John, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Simon, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. The servant of God, Martha, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Demetrius, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. The servant of God, Alexander, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ. The handmaid of God, Photini, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Marianne, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Deacon Peter, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Joanne, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Maria, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Boris, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Reader Jeffrey, receives most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Maria, receives most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Nina, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Reader Paul, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, John, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Thomas, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, John, receives, Andrew, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Johannes, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, unto remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, Hieromant Nicolai, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ. The servant of God, Marcus, receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and to remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen. The servant of God, subdeacon Peter, receives receives the most precious, pure, and holy body and blood of Christ. Metlaveni duli tu Theou Vasiliki, tu tibiu somatos caematos Christou, is afisinamation keso in eonion. Amen. The Son of God, Nicholas the Reader, receives the most precious, pure, and holy body and blood of Christ. Metlaveni odulos tu Theou Dimitrios, tu tibiu somatos caematos Christou, is afisinamation keso in eonion. Amen. Servant of God Anna receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and for remission of sins, the servant of God Emmanuel receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ. The servant of God Miriam receives the most precious, pure and holy body and blood of Christ, and for remission of sins and life everlasting. Amen.
Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house, glorify them in return by your divine power,
and do not forsake us who hope in you. Give peace to your world, to your churches, to priests, to our rulers, to all your people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from you, the Father of lights. And to you we give glory, thanksgiving, and worship to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Ito onoma Kyriou evlogimenon apo tounin ke eleos tou eono. Blessed be the name of the Lord from this time forth and forevermore. Ito onoma Kyriou evlogimenon apo tounin ke
by his divine grace and love for mankind, always, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God and our hope. Glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Master,
may he who rose from the dead, Christ our true God, at the prayers of his most pure and holy Mother, by the power of the precious and life-giving cross, at the protection of the honored spiritual powers of heaven, at the intercessions of the honored and glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all-praised apostles, of the holy, glorious, and all-praised equal to the Apostles Mary Magdalene, to whom this church is dedicated, all the holy new martyrs and confessors of the land of Russia, whose memory we celebrate today, all the holy great martyr Theodore Stratilates, the chief general, whose day it also is, all our Father among the saints, Salva Archbishop of Serbia, of the holy prophet Zechariah, of the holy hermit of Staining Cuthman, whose day it also is, of the holy righteous forbearers of God, Joachim and Anna, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose liturgy we have celebrated, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us. For he is good, and he loves mankind.
Dones potitiae archielaimon, Kyrie philater, his fola et idespota, his fola et idespota, his fola.
The blessing of the Lord be upon you. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. Evlogia Kyriou ke Elios Elthiepimas. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. 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 Christ is in our midst. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. Christ is in our midst. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. 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 The blessing of the Lord. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. 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 The blessing of the Lord. The blessing of the Lord. The blessing of the Lord. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. 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 The blessing of the Lord. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. 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 Christ is in our midst. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. The blessing of the Lord. Thank you very much for letting us use the chapel, church once more. The blessing of the Lord. The blessing of the Lord. The blessing of the Lord. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. The blessing of the Lord. 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 The blessing of the Lord be upon you. 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 Evlogia Kyriou ke Elios. Evlogia Kyriou ke Elios. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. That's only crumbs for you. The blessing of the Lord be upon you. Glory to thee, O God. Glory to thee, O God. Glory to thee, O God. Thank you very much, Father.
I thank you for giving to the house of me the unworthy, worthy to share in your most pure and heavenly gifts. But master lover of mankind,
who died for our sake and rose again and gave us these your awe-inspiring and life-giving mysteries for the well-being and hallowing of our souls and bodies. Grant that these gifts may bring me also healing of soul and body, the repelling of every adversary, the enlightenment of the eyes of my heart, peace of my spiritual powers, faith unashamed, love without pretense, fullness of wisdom and the keeping of your commandments, increase of your divine grace and the gaining of your kingdom, that preserved through them by your sanctification, I may always remember your grace and no longer live for myself but for you, our master and benefactor. I thank you, Lord my God, because you have not rejected me a sinner, but have counted me worthy to be a communicant of your holy things. And so, when I leave this present life in the hope of life eternal, I shall find everlasting repose, where the sound of those whose feast is unceasing, and the delight of those who see the ineffable beauty of your face is unbounded. For you are the true desire and the inexpressible joy of those who love you, Christ our God, and all creation hymns you to the ages. Amen. Master Christ God, King of the ages and Creator of all things, I thank you for all the good things you have given me, and for communion in your most pure and life-giving mysteries. Therefore, I pray you, O good one, lover of mankind, guard me under your protection and in the shadow of your wings, and grant that until my last breath I shall share worthily and with a pure conscience in your holy things, for forgiveness of sins and everlasting life. For you are the bread of life, the source of sanctification, the giver of blessings, and to you we give glory, with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. You who willingly gave me your flesh for food, who are a fire consuming the unworthy, do not burn me up, my Maker, but penetrate the structure of my limbs, all my joints, my inner parts, my heart. Burn up the thorns of all my offences, purify my soul and sanctify my mind. Strengthen my knees together with my bones, enlighten the fivefold simpleness of my senses, nail down the whole of me with fear of you. Always protect, guard, and keep me from every soul-destroying deed and word. Hallow me, purify me, bring me to harmony, and give me beauty, understanding, light. Show me to be your dwelling, the Spirit's house alone, and no more the dwelling place of sin, that by the entrance of communion, every evildoer, every passion may flee from me, your house, as from a fire. As intercessors, I bring you all the saints, the companies of the bodiless hosts, your forerunner, the wise apostles, and with them your most pure and holy mother. Accept their prayers, O my compassionate Christ, and make your servant a child of light. For you alone are the sanctifying of our souls, O good one, and their brightness. And fittingly to you, as to our God and Master, we all give praise and glory every day. May your holy body, Lord Jesus Christ our God, bring me eternal life, and your precious blood forgiveness of sins. May this Eucharist bring me joy, health, and gladness, and at your dread second coming make me a sinner, worthy to stand at the right hand of your glory. At the prayers of your all-pure Mother, and of all your saints, Amen. All Holy Lady, Mother of God, the light of my darkened soul, my hope, protection, refuge, comfort, joy, I thank you because you have made me the unworthy, worthy to become a partaker in the most pure body and precious blood of your Son. But, O you who gave birth to the true light, enlighten the spiritual eyes of my heart. You who bore the source of immortality, give life to me who have been slain by sin. You, the compassionate Mother of the merciful God, have mercy on me and give me compunction and contrition in my heart and humility in my ideas and release from the imprisonment of my thoughts. And count me worthy until my last breath to receive without condemnation the hallowing of the most pure mysteries for healing of soul and body, and grant me tears of repentance and thanksgiving to praise and glorify you all the days of my life. For you are blessed and glorified to the ages. Amen.
You are blessed and glorified to the ages. Amen.
For you are blessed and glorified to the ages. Amen.
Lord, may this is thy servant depart in peace according to thy word, for thine eyes have seen thy salvation, praise for thee. The light of revelation to the nations and the glory of the people.
Holy God, holy strong, holy most have mercy for us. Holy God, holy strong, holy most have mercy for us. Holy God, holy strong, holy most have mercy for us. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen.
The grace which shone from your mouth like a torch of flame enlightened the whole earth. It laid up for the world the treasures of freedom from avarice. It showed us the height of humility. But as you train us by your words, Father John Chrysostom, intercede with Christ God the Word that our souls may be saved. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. You receive divine grace from heaven, and through your lips you teach us all to worship one God in Trinity, Venerable John Chrysostom, Holy Blessed. Fittingly we praise you, for you are a teacher who makes clear things divine, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. At the prayers of all your saints, and of the Mother of God, grant us your peace, O Lord, and have mercy on us, for you alone are compassionate. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Greater in honour than the cherubim, and beyond compare more glorious than the seraphim, without corruption you gave birth to God the Word. Truly, the Mother of God, we magnify you. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Master, give the blessing.
May he who rose from the dead, Christ, our true God, with the presence of all pure and holy Mother, by the holy glorious and praise apostles, of our Father and our saints, John Christian, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose liturgy was celebrated, with the holy righteous forebears of us, the earth and the heaven of all the saints. Have mercy upon us and save us, for he is good and loves mankind.
Amen.